Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. We hope you enjoyed our coverage from CES last week, and stay tuned. After this week's news, we'll have some more news from the show. We'll start this week with two bills going through the U.S. Congress that have made the internet erupt with criticism and protest. Some have even taken to the streets to rally against the two bills, SOPA and PIPA, which would supposedly help media companies combat online piracy.
There are no borders. That fundamentally changes how we think. I think that people in Washington and in the rest of the world don't think this way. I think we need to start educating people around the world about how our technology works. And I hate to say it, but we can't geek out when we do that.
Some of the biggest cheers came for Craigslist founder Craig Newmark, who echoed the prevailing feeling among the crowd that if they passed, SOPA and PIPA would shut down existing websites within Silicon Valley.
You know, the internet, a lot of people who use the internet were now getting wise to the fact that we have to take some responsibility for this. I mean, I learned from a nerd named Gutenberg that you gotta be responsible for your own PR, otherwise you're gonna die broke, and we don't want that to happen to us. We gotta take some charge.
Both bills have taken a hit in the last week as their authors have decided to remove the provisions that require internet service providers to block the domain names of infringing sites. SOPA, which has yet to pass out of the House Judiciary Committee, is reportedly stalled. Voting on PIPA, however, is scheduled to begin in the Senate on January 24th. It's the end of an era for Yahoo as co-founder Jerry Yang announced his complete resignation this Tuesday. Yang was heavily involved in Yahoo's growth from a popular search engine in the 90s to a broader web portal that provided online communication services and content. However, financial struggles in recent years tarnished the company's image as it failed to keep up with competition. One analyst said that Yang's lack of media expertise makes him somewhat unnecessary if Yahoo intends to compete in the new digital world. Yang's resignation came only days after former PayPal president Scott Thompson was named Yahoo's CEO. As for his future, Yang said he intends to pursue other interests outside Yahoo. Sony is teasing something called Dot Switch that in this video looks like it's designed to control multiple devices. The remote is what appears to be a Sony Ericsson handset, and it's possible that it could be using IR to power up devices. IR wouldn't be unusual to still add to a gadget. The company's Tablet S, which recently went on sale, has it too. We're looking to learn more on February 21st, which is what the company advertises at the end of the clip. Coincidentally, that's a day before the PlayStation Vita launches in Europe and North America. NASA and data from the International Space Station were stolen from Japan's space agency, JAXA, after the group discovered a Trojan infection was on one of its employees' computers. Up to 1,000 email addresses, login details for the agency's intranet, and NASA documents covering operation of the ISS were lost. Given the employees' work on the Jackson H-2 transfer vehicle, the HTV, nicknamed Kanatori, the agency is worried that the latest infection could also have given hackers access to data on the project. The H-2 is an unmanned vehicle used to ferry supplies to the ISS and was first launched in 2009, with a second takeoff scheduled for Sunday, the 22nd. The heated battle between Apple and Samsung in Germany rages on as another lawsuit comes into play. Aimed at 10 models of the company's Galaxy S smartphones, Apple feels that Samsung's products look too much like its own. This is consistent with Apple's attack on Samsung's tablet last year, when they argued the design too closely resembled the iPad. Samsung did change the design, but it seems like Apple isn't done fighting yet. The smartphone case will come before the court in August. Last week at CES, I got to try out the AR Drone 2 from France-based Parrot. They've been on our radar for 2 years since they debuted the first drone. This updated version is much easier to fly and significantly sturdier than the first copter. One new feature that makes it easier to fly is a setting that makes the AR drone fly in reference to the pilot. So forward is forward, left is left, and so on, regardless of which way the copter is rotated. That makes piloting much easier. One of the concerns I had, though, was battery life with all these new components.
Well, what we did for me is a big improvement, not because it has more time, because it's still the same 12 minutes, but because you're doing a lot more things within that time, especially with the HD camera, you know, it needs a lot of power.
The AR Drone 2 will be available in the second quarter this year for $300. Many of us have been there. You've dropped your phone in a puddle, the toilet, or the ocean. Electronics and water have a history of not getting along until now. A small company made a big splash at last week's CES by waterproofing not just the outside of the device, but their internal components. HZO showed off WaterBlock. The company said they're in talks with a number of device makers to offer this option at little to no cost to the consumer.
By making it available through the manufacturing process, I don't think they'll even increase the cost of the phone. You won't even know it's there price-wise.
He said they looked at an aftermarket option, but it turned out to be too expensive. If device makers use the technology, this system would integrate into their existing manufacturing process. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. To find out what's coming up on every week's show, be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. As we head out, we'll leave you with some clips from the Bahrain International Air Show. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.